is that we all inhabit this small planet. We all breathe the same air. We all cherish our children's future. And we are all mortal. Thank you very much for this.
I decided that this is something that I want to do with my life. And every year, globally, there is a big celebration across the world called the International Women's Day. And one of those days, I was sitting in my office as we're coming close to International Women's Day. And I called my staff and said, you know what? I feel like it's just a choir celebrating choir day. We need to do something new and dramatic for International Women's Day. We have a whole generation of young women who should follow in our footsteps. What can we do to bring them along as we celebrate International Women's Day? We sat down, brainstormed, and quickly we had the idea for spending International Women's Day with young women from Ghana, from very poor communities, or bringing activists to interact with them into a space we call Why We Fight. Because we realized that a lot of the young women in our communities have no idea what's the drive. Why do these women stand in the street with placards picketing? Why are they on the radio as the former U.S. ambassador to the Security Council called one of my presentations ranting? Why are they always ranting about women's rights issue? So we started that. And that's why I think this journey has been challenging because, and I'm sure the Millennium Campus Network can kind of like agree with me, regardless of how great your work is, raising funds is the hardest thing. Convincing donors that this is something that is going to make impact is difficult, especially when you're dealing with people and you can't check the number of people who receive notebooks and pens and pads. So we went to one of the donors in Ghana and said, this is what we want to do. Fantastic idea. And the way I know how to do my work, and I say my work, because that's all I've been doing all my life, working with people. Sometimes it's not in the textbooks. It's just about making them feel good about themselves.
You see changes. And we thought, if we talk these young women from the poorest neighborhood
in Ghana and carry them to the most expensive hotel in Ghana and put them with the biggest names that they only get to see on TV, is going to stir something up in them. The donors came back to us and said, why do you want to do that? Your poor kids from slum communities have this thing in one of the town halls in their community. We were looking for only $5,000. And they came back to tell us we can't give you 5,000 cents. My staff members were so depressed. And I told them, even if you're removing heaven and earth, we'll find the money and we'll do the work. We got one of the African Women's NGOs to fund us, the African Women Development Fund. We brought those girls in and I sat on the platform observing them as they came in. Wide eye, open mouth. And as they got seated, one after the other, women activists filled the hall. And as these women passed, but one of the women did the most amazing thing. As she passed by those girls sitting, she recognized their uniform and went and broke into a Twi song. Twi is a local language. And the song was simply telling the girls, one big cup of water to one small cup of starch, few cups of glue makes your uniform look good. And she danced the dance. These little girls were shocked. This is the song of their school. But this is the president's advisor on gender issue. This is the government representative at the Economic Community of West African States when it comes to women's issue. This is someone who they see on TV every day. How come? And she told them, this is the school I started in. Just by accident, that school was in the room. I've never had a meeting where people would not want to leave immediately. We ended that session at 4:30. The women and the girls just hung around till 6. The reviews we've gotten from those little girls, from Muslim homes to Christian homes to typically traditional homes. Thank you. That space changed my life. I want to be somebody. But more than that, if those women came from where I came from and they've succeeded today, I'm going to succeed. It will take years for us to know which of them became ministers, or maybe presidents and prime ministers and bankers and lawyers. But what is important to me is the joy that filled them as they left that room. And I told my staff members later on, those donors lost out on a very beautiful moment. I can stand here and tell you stories upon stories of challenges, of very rewarding things. And every time I step into a space where my work is recognized, be it the Nobel, be it the Millennium Campus Network recognizing me, I say to myself, it's not about you. It's about those young women and young men and women in communities where you just walk into and sit down and let them be who they want to be. And let them grow out to be what they want to be. And let them challenge their structures the way they want to challenge their structures. And sometimes people ask me, don't you get tired of flying? Or don't you get tired of being in cars? And I say no. Because the joy that I get from those communities is the true essence of the work that I do. I want to say thank you. Again, this is a reaffirmation that I'm not crazy. This is a reaffirmation that God's work that we're doing is not just hitting empty walls. Thank you so much. And it means so much to me to be recognized by this group. And I just want to promise you that we will continue on this journey, speaking loudly when it's necessary, being well-behaved to women when it's necessary, or being badly behaved women when it's necessary to make history. Thank you.